Hi, David again. I want to respond to a comment that someone sent me just a couple of minutes ago. I had not a lot of time to think about it, but I certainly thought about the subject many times. The comments mostly that I'm getting are from active LDS people that have some kind of a diagnosis for me. In the LDS Mormon psychic, in this cult, there is no room for anything but black and white. Cults are that way. You can't live anywhere in the gray or ask questions or to make assumptions about a gray area. You're either in or you're out. You're either right or you're wrong. The comments I think I'm getting are certainly from younger LDS people. I'm 64, and this isn't my first rodeo. And some of these 28 and 35-year-old people, they're not rude. I've had no one be rude to me. I've had no one be obnoxious. They have certainly a right to their opinions, and in my world, everyone has a right to speak their opinion and to express themselves according to their own conscience. That wasn't the way it was in the LDS Church. You write a comment like some you've done to me, to the general authorities, you won't be a member. In my world, you're honored and you're welcome, and I certainly enjoy your comments, the ability to debate, and the ability to look at my own reasons and my own processing. Am I seeing things and expressing them the way I want to? Am I being true and faithful? So I want you to know that the comments are welcome. And I'm certainly not going to come back and call you an idiot, a fool, a sheep, whatever. You're a human being, and I know what it's like to be caught up in a cult. That's the way I was for 50 years. Now, some people have commented that I'm angry, and I'm kind of evaluating that. And I'm going to have to say, on certain levels, you bet your ass I'm angry. When you spend 50 years of your life working two jobs, raising 14 children, and being married, whatever it's been, four or five times, and paying 10% of your income to a religion that you believe that you're trying to live and you're trying to be perfect, and then suddenly realize you can't be perfect, you've had your childhood robbed, and you've had your adulthood robbed. You have no friends except in the Mormon cult. You haven't developed any social skills because the Mormon cult doesn't require them. And you find yourself towards the twilight of your life, and I'm gonna say it, you know, I try not to be crude and rude on my videos, but I can only behave for a few minutes, and those are up. But I really feel like I'm have been up shit creek without a paddle, and that makes one angry. And I'm going to say not just one, that makes me angry. Now, I'm certainly not as angry as I was when I first discovered that this whole thing was a fraud. There's a website called Recovery from Mormonism. .com that Steve Benson, Pulitzer Prize winner, former Mormon and the grandson of Ezra Taft Benson, one of your apostle prophets of the Mormon Church, frequents the site and supports the site. I've been on the site for 4 or 5 years trying to get control of my anger, get control of my thought process to become a good person, to become acceptable to myself and hopefully to the world and my family in general. And one of the things that you find with Mormons is when they discover someone out of the religion that has not been excommunicated, there is no such thing. They're trained that you are offended and the church is perfect, but the people in it aren't. Or their other category is that you have been sexually promiscuous and you've been excommunicated because of that practice. When you resign from the Mormon Church because you have discovered that their doctrine is not true, that's like talking to the wall when you say that to a Mormon. It doesn't compute. It's kind of like Data there on Star Trek. He's not programmed to hear those things. And so when Mormon people see people like me, they only have two categories. I don't fit in either one. They don't know what to do. So they kind of throw themselves onto the ground like a 2-year-old and start thrashing and saying, "Well, you're angry. You're mentally ill." Those are true statements. Those are pretty much true. I have been much more angry. I'm not as angry these days. I was this morning a little bit because I had to talk to a Mormon for an hour and about drove me nuts. But I'm not angry like I was. Boy, I was angry, and I've met a lot of recovered LDS people who know what I'm talking about, the anger that's there. Your whole life has been ruined, and you're trying to put it back together at 50, 55, 60 years old. You have no family, no friends, and everything was inside the box. You've stepped outside the box, and it's scary coming out. So there's people that have advised me to continue to try to lure my kids into relationships with me, and that things can always be reinvented, reestablished, etc. Let me say this very, very clear. Now that I am out of that cult, and I can think left and right, up and down, I can read anything I want, say anything I want. The church doesn't hold any powers and terrorize me and scare me that I'm going to be excommunicated, I'm going to lose my family. You know, all of those trickery things basically have dissolved. I am happier. I am happier. Yeah, I had an attempted suicide about 4 or 5 months ago, trying to go back to work, and the work was too stressful. And I have bipolar disorder. I've said that openly on my videos. And that's not indicative of me not being happy. If people know anything about suicide, it doesn't mean that a person is totally unhappy. They can be very eventful suicides caused by just something very quick in the society, especially with bipolar. 33% of the bipolar people in the world kill themselves. We don't die of natural causes. So to try to link that with Mormonism, there's some justification to that because I link it that much of the stress that the Mormon Church brought upon me caused attempted suicides. I've had, I believe, 5 attempts and only one since I've left the church. So I blame the other four, I guess, on the church. But I'm not interested in having the Mormon Church or my ex-wives or my children control me anymore. I've been controlled enough by this cult, and I'm free now. Like Martin Luther King, if I could change colors, I would. Free at last, free at last, free at last. And I don't want to be a Mormon. I hate it. And it is a extremely destructive cult that is subliminal, and the effects of it are not seen for years and years. So the only way Mormon people can listen to me or look at me say, "Well, he must have been sexually promiscuous. He's excommunicated. He's disfellowshipped. He's mad at the church." I'm not mad at the church. They didn't do any of that. It's impossible almost to offend me. I mean, I'm an unoffendable person, so I'm not offended. So now, see, there's no category for them to categorize and stereotype and put me in a pocket. So now they flop around mentally, flashing from you're not really happy, even though I smile and I laugh a lot, and I love taking my kids to school. I go to their PTA conferences now, which I never did, never had time when I was a Mormon. And I have 2 brand new cars, and I have a brand new condo. And I've been on vacation, see, here's the thing with Mormonism. This is the beautiful, beautiful part of their cult. They cannot lose. If you leave them and you do poorly, They'll say, "See, you left us, and God is punishing you." But if you have new cars and a condo and you travel and a beautiful wife is 23 years your senior and you're just having a fun time, they say, "The devil pays well." You can't win with these people. You can't win. How can you argue with those two arguments? It's perfect circular cult talk and belief. So I just want to give the courtesy of responding back. When people are kind enough to say, "Hey, you know, I don't believe what you believe," I don't want to just ignore them, and I don't want to bash them and accuse them of stupidity and other kinds of punitive. See, Mormons are very, very punitive. Their church is very punitive and fearful to them, and they want to respond to me that I'm a hateful person, and I'm not sure that I'm hateful. I think that those feelings pretty much are gone. I find a lot of this comical. Now, is this a hateful face? I don't know. Maybe it is. Maybe it's subliminal, and being in psychology, maybe it's a projection. It could be a thousand things. But I've laughed more. I've smiled more. I have worked for Meals on Wheels as a volunteer and have helped over at the senior center, and I've worked at the schools and volunteered. I've done a lot of things since I got out of the cult that make me happy, and you know the thing I enjoy the most is doing nothing. Just sitting here in front of my camera, looking at my face and going, "Hey, you're free. The bishop can't call you. He can't scare you anymore. You don't have to go home teaching. Your lesson for Sunday is not prepared yet, and two kids are giving a talk, and your wife is on a release aside." You know, I'm not there anymore, guys. So if the Mormon church floats your boat and you really are happy and you really feel good, I say go for it. Don't try to make me have words in my mouth that I'm trying to pull anybody out of the Mormon church. You like it? Stay. Wear more glasses. Wear more white shirts. Sit in more boring meetings. And man, you'll move right on up. Because you're in a cult. To raise in a cult, all you have to do is nothing. Nothing is by merit. Everything is spiritual. You're raised up by the Spirit. And the men who raise you up, raise themselves up. So, am I angry? I used to be. Sometimes my buttons get pushed when the missionaries come in our area and try to tract when we have a no solicitation sign up. Mormons don't usually follow the rules, even if they're federal or state, like Johnson's Army and the Mountain Meadows Massacre. But thank you for making comments. Thank you for taking that much interest. And I don't agree with you, and you don't agree with me, but the nice thing about it is you don't have to, and I don't either. Thanks. Appreciate your comments, and I wish you the best.